The Minor Basilica of Santa Sabina is located on the Aventine Hill, overlooking the Tiber River, above the noise and busyness of the city. This Paleo-Christian church was built upon one of the house churches where the first Christians of Rome would gather. In this case, the house of a woman named Sabina, who was converted to the faith through one of her servants. Later martyred in the Umbrian region of Italy, her relics were returned to this church and now rest under the main altar. Fragments of the underlying Roman villa can be seen in several points along the nave wall. The church was consecrated in 432 under the pontificate of Pope Celestine I and has been substantially unchanged since this original construction in the Roman basilica style. It has a single nave lined with a number of small windows, and the apse is set apart by a scola cantorum. A restoration in the 9th century by Pope Eugene III added the chancery furnishings with Cosmatesque decorations. It was for a time the residence of the Holy Father, and also the location of one of the longest conclaves to elect a Holy Roman Pontiff, which lasted nearly a year. A side chapel dedicated to St. Catherine was added in the 17th century when the church was redecorated in the Renaissance style. It was later refurbished in the Baroque style, but finally returned to its original in the 20th century. It retains a sober form, having lost all its original mosaics over the course of the centuries and various restorations. However, over the main doors, the original dedication of the church remains, with two women on either side representing the two churches from which Christianity came: the Church of the Circumcision, those who were Jews, and the Church of the Gentiles. The cypress wood doors of the main entrance are decorated with a cycle of carvings dating to the 5th century, part of the original construction. They contain a panel with the earliest surviving image of the crucifixion of Jesus. The only remaining tombstone within the church is that of a Grand Master of the Dominicans, dating from the 14th century. This church was entrusted to the newly founded Dominican order in the 13th century, and it remains their general house to the present day. Saint Dominic, their founder, Saint Thomas Aquinas, and many other Dominican brothers have lived in the adjacent convent throughout the years. It includes an orange tree sprouted from one that was planted by Saint Dominic himself, which can be seen through a small hole in the cloister wall. According to the Roman tradition, which goes back to the early 600s, the Ash Wednesday Mass is celebrated yearly by the Holy Father in this church. In this church, a place of prayer for so many centuries, we contemplate the power of prayer and its importance in the life of all the faithful. As Pope Benedict XVI explained during his homily for Ash Wednesday in this church, prayer nourishes hope, because nothing expresses the reality of God in our life better than praying with faith. Even in the loneliness of the most severe trials, nothing and no one can prevent me from addressing the Father in the secret of my heart, where He alone sees, as Jesus says in the Gospel. Mother Adela Galindo explains, "When prayer is first, it means that God is first in our life. May God always be first." Let us pray together the prayer that Jesus taught us, praying together to our Heavenly Father. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen.